welcome to I'm Every Woman TV. I'm your host, Jeanette Burke, your marketing magnet, and I'm here filming live from the ET Canada party, TIFF party. We're celebrating 7 years of great ET stories with ET tonight and all their wonderful co-hosts. I just had a chat with Rick Minnello. It's such a pleasure to be here because I've always wanted to do a show on women in TV and film. And what a perfect opportunity to be able to do that than here, right here at TIFF. So stay with us as I'm going to bring you all the answers to the questions you want to know. And I'm going to get some very powerful information that I hope you will use to see yourself through the eyes of these very talented homegrown entertainers and international entertainers who are here tonight, that you might be able to see yourself in them and get some courage and some muster to know that you can accomplish anything that you set your mind to. And you'll hear some very inspirational stories.
The best moments for me are the live moments. The moments that you put out there and you can't really get back. You never know what to expect and what's going to be happening. So those moments are obviously the best for me. Our live Grammy show, our live shows out from Vancouver. We're going back out there next month. So live TV, definitely my best moments.
And since you work with some heavy-duty women, I want to know what it's like to work with some heavy-duty women. What kind of influence do they have on you? Do they make you better?
Well, Cheryl is the best co-host you can ask for in the world. You know, she's fun, she's gorgeous, she's smart, she knows her stuff. So working with someone like that on a day-to-day basis is amazing. So, yeah, you learn from someone like that. And we sort of grown too over the last 7 years. Like I didn't know her going into this job, and she actually feels like, you know, my younger sister. You know, I feel protective when we go away, when
I'm
we go out into the field,
and
yeah, younger sister. I'm much older than her, but yeah, those things.
Look like a baby.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, and I'll ask you one last question.
Yeah,
so I know you have to go.
It's okay.
If you weren't living this dream, what dream would you be living?
It really is a dream, because I was going to be a phys ed teacher. Like, I fell into this world of TV, and I'm quite fortunate. I think if I was just doing about anything in life, like teaching, whatever, I'm not going to put the list out there, but as long as I have my family to support me and my loved ones and my close friends, whatever I'd be doing, I'd be happy. I really would be. I lucked out. I lucked out with this job. I did, Jeanette, so.
You seem like a very contented type of guy, and I have to tell you, I absolutely loved your trip to Italy special.
Oh, thank you.
That
thank
was
you.
Amazing.
Well, let's hope David Rocco shows up tonight.
Yeah, that would be nice.
We'll see.
Okay, thank you so
thank
much
you very
for
much.
Talking
nice to
me.
My pleasure.
I'm Every Woman TV. I like that already.
That women love to cook.
Yes, of course.
And you're a great celebrity chef. So
yes.
Please share with me one good secret for my lady viewers.
One good secret.
Yes. If you wanted to make something really, really quick, what would you?
Really,
make?
Really quick.
Yeah.
I mean, come on.
And be an impressive hostess. On a night when you have to run home because you've been working all day, and your husband calls you and he says, "Honey, I'm bringing somebody home for dinner," and she's like, "Oh my God, what do I do?"
That
what
is.
Did she do?
Oh my, that's
just
a tall
a
order.
One.
Yeah, a quick
no,
one.
No pressure.
Wait a minute, a quick one with her husband.
No,
a quick pasta. A quick pasta dish. Okay, yeah. Now you're getting me confused over here, all of these questions. Very simple. Okay. Everyone always loves a nice aglio olio. We are still in the beautiful middle of the summer over here, right? I mean, a little bit of fresh tomatoes, some garlic, some oil. What can be wrong? A nice glass of wine? Don't sweat it. Do not sweat it. I see everyone always overdoes it. In the kitchen, you got to keep things simple.
Like in life.
Like in life, exactly, exactly.
Okay, well, thank you so much.
You're
and
very
have
welcome.
A wonderful evening.
Oh, I will. Thank you.
Okay. I'm chilling.
Oh.
I'm so like cash.
You're now speaking with, I'm Jeanette Burke, and I'm the host and creator of I'm Every Woman TV.
Oh, I love that.
Thank
I'm, yeah.
You know the Shaka Khan song?
Oh, yes, of
yes,
course.
Of
yeah.
Course. It's now a show I created.
Oh, okay.
So I'd like you to tell me something for my women viewers.
Mm-hmm.
And I want it to be a little bit inspirational. What's the hardest thing you've had to do to fulfill your dream?
The hardest thing that I've had to do to fulfill my dreams? Oh boy, that's a good question. The hardest thing that I had to do, because honestly, you know what? The hardest thing I had to do to try to fulfill my dreams in the beginning of my career was I tried to be something that I wasn't, right? So in the beginning, because I didn't own who I was, right? I, you know, try to conform in order to fit in, right? And that was pretty hard, like trying to, be somebody else, right? And until I, does that make sense?
It sure does. Yeah. You're telling me you weren't being authentic.
I wasn't being authentic to who Stacey McKenzie is, like my looks. I would do things like, you know, drawing my eyebrows, try to change my hair color, try to hide my freckles, trying to, change my voice, you know, and I wasn't being authentic to who Stacey McKenzie is, right?
And when you stopped all that, is that when you saw the success?
When I stopped all that and I decided, like, you know what? I have this one vessel. It's important for me to love and own and accept who I am and be me, right? Once I started owning me, loving me and owning me, even if my dreams wasn't meant for me, at least I know who I was, you know, at least I know I have a strong sense of self and I was able to go out and, like, pursue whatever it is that I wanted to pursue in life, right? So, yeah.
Well, congratulations.
Thank
I think
you.
You've done very well. I love the message that you just gave me and my female viewers.
Oh, thank you.
And I want to wish you a fantastic night.
Thank you.
And have fun upstairs, and maybe we'll see you later.
Yeah. What up? I'm Every Woman. I love, love, love that you're a positive influence on the women of today.
I'm doing good this evening, yes.
Great. Okay. As you know, I just mentioned I'm doing a woman show. And I'd like to know, who is the greatest woman influence in your life?
Well, that's
that
easy.
You become who you are today.
That's an easy answer. I would probably say my mom and my grandmother.
Okay, and what did they do specifically to ensure that you are who you are today?
They prayed for me every day. They prayed for me every day ever since I was born. And I think that's... this on the spiritual side is really great, but I think they just show me what life is all about, and I think they're the two that really taught me about what giving back to your community and giving back to others and loving and all those things that is a part of me and who I am, and I'm not just a football player, but I can play that tough sport, but I understand what it's all about, and it's about other people and making other people's lives much better.
Well, thank you so much. That was a really powerful answer.
Yes, right.
I love your
Thank
stuff.
You. Thank
and
you.
Let's get a shot of your back. Excellent.
Black diamonds. You like
yes,
it?
I love. Yeah. Okay, I love black diamonds. Yeah. I love any diamond.
Okay,
how about
good.
That? You see, I'm a blinger.
Oh, okay. Great. My kind of
so,
girl.
Mark, I do a show strictly for women called I'm Every Woman.
Great.
And I'm sure you love to make women feel special.
I do.
I mean,
definitely.
I actually in the business of doing
definitely.
That. Yeah. If a woman could only afford one piece of jewelry, what would you advise her to start with, and why?
Probably a single diamond, because a single diamond you can always do something with. Later if she wants to make a pendant out of it, make a ring out of it. We've had a lot of clients that come in that buy a single diamond in a pendant or a ring, and then later, as they get into the working world. I had somebody come in recently, said, this is the first diamond that I bought for you. I made it as a ring, and now I want to get a bigger diamond for my finger, and I want to match one for diamond studs. Now she has her diamond studs. She can always add it to a necklace, so I would say a diamond.
And for the independent woman, which there are many out there today, who are actually purchasing their own diamonds.
That's right.
What do you have to say about that? What are you for it, against it? Oh, I think you got a call.
Yeah, that's okay. It's probably one of my customers wondering where all her diamonds are. I think definitely, why not? I mean, if somebody's working and they're working hard, and they should be able to buy themselves beautiful things. I think it's great.
I agree. Well, have a wonderful
Thank
time
you very
much. Tonight.
Thank you. Nice meeting you.
I have been TIFF partying. I'm a little tired.
I like that.
Yeah.
Cool.
Have you been?
Good. I've also been TIFF partying, but I guess I didn't see you.
I know. Where have you been?
Well,
all my life.
I was, were you at the Hello Canada?
Yeah, we were.
We
came late.
Were you at the Norman Jewison barbecue?
No,
That was a good one.
I was a little hungover still.
Okay, so now you gotta share me some tidbits. Please introduce yourself to the camera.
Hi, my name is Kwasi Akufo.
I'm Brock McLaughlin.
And you guys are from?
I work at Wax Records as management.
And I am a artist,
okay,
musician.
Artist. All right, so I'm a woman. I'm the host and creator of I'm Every Woman TV. It's Jeanette here. You got it.
I got you, girl.
So I need you to give me some a question or some good advice for women. You're working as an executive.
Yeah.
Have you seen the executive roles change for women in your office lately? You see more representation there or not really? Is it a mess?
Not at our label, but definitely in the music scene. There's a lot of women in the music scene, and they're killing it. They're all doing very good.
And is that as artists or behind the scenes?
Behind the scenes. Oh, yeah, for sure. They're behind the scenes.
Killing it. What are they killing?
They're getting the job done far better than the men in most cases. They're doing the PR. They're managing the bands. They're doing the tour managing. They're everything. They're doing a great job.
So the women have a great role in the industry of the music
industry. Absolutely.
Yes.
I have the highest respect.
Okay, great. I'm glad to hear that. Now, you're an artist.
Yeah. Yes.
What are you working on presently?
Right now, we're working on a new single called Free Your Mind, which will be out at the end of September or mid-October. And then single after single all the way to Christmas and then South by in March.
Okay, so tell me, how do you free your mind?
The song Free Your Mind is kind of a naughty. I'm like Prince of hip hop now.
Okay,
if Prince wants to come
Prince.
Back, I'll be.
Tell me how you free your mind.
Okay, I got you a new thing. It's her plus me. It's gonna be good. It's gonna be really bad. She's out here working up the elementary because 1 + 1 = 2, or 2 + 1 = 1 for me and you.
So. Okay, I'll keep that in mind. Okay, good luck with your new album.
Thank you,
Mom. Thank you for stopping
by. Thank you.
By.
It was a real pleasure to meet you.
You too.
Cheers.
You're a charmer like Thank that. You. And I'm now with I'm Every Woman TV, which is
You
my,
are every woman.
That's
you represent
right.
every woman.
I am, and I am host and creator, and I'm on alltalktv.com now.
Alltalktv.com.
So, Lyric, it's been a year. What have you been up to?
I've been up to a whole lot of naughty things.
Oh, really? Do tell. I want to hear.
No, well, we have Rookie Blue going on season 4, so
yes,
that's
just finished that.
No, we just started. Season 3 just ended.
Oh, sorry.
But we're
mistake.
shooting season 4, which is fabulous. I think the viewers are going to be really, really happy with what we got going on for next season. And my film premieres tomorrow.
Which is what?
It's called Home Again. And I'm home again at TIFF.
Okay.
Premiering this film, and it's oh so exciting.
Well, it sounds really good.
Yes.
Okay, so now, because we are a woman show,
yes.
I gotta ask you something to do with women.
Of course, because
okay.
I love women.
I know you do.
And I know I got
I
the answer for
do.
The women.
I know you have
I got the answers for you.
You know, talk for them and the looks and everything. And I know they love watching you.
Thank
but,
you.
But, you know, I wanna ask you seriously, like, who is the best woman you ever worked with?
The best
why?
Woman that I've worked with.
Yeah.
Wow.
Why?
That, you know what? I really
it
couldn't say that
be,
because...
It doesn't have to be a co-star. It could be even somebody behind the scenes who impacted your life.
Well, you know, I mean, I don't want to be cliche, but I mean, my mom was the best woman I worked with. She got me my first real job where she was working. And it was at a nursing home. And
oh, you acted in a nursing home?
No, I worked at a nursing home.
Oh.
And she got me that job, my mom. And I got a chance to see how she had to work really hard to put a roof over my head and food on my table. And in that, I realized that she really sacrificed for me. And learning from those elderly was the best I can do because they've experienced life. And sometimes you want to learn best from other people. And so that is very monumental to me.
Now, do you draw upon any of that when you go to act?
Absolutely.
Every
Absolutely.
Day to make it real?
Absolutely. Because of that experience, I'm able to do what I do because I haven't experienced a lot of things in life. And I don't necessarily want to experience certain things in order to know what it's like. So those conversations with those beautiful
elders really defined my understanding of what it is that I needed to portray and understand about my characters.
Okay, so I guess you're pushing off to some other parties
I
now?
I am.
So I'm glad I caught you before you left, because it can't be TIFF without me talking to the lyric.
Thank you.
Happy birthday, Team Canada!
Oh, yay!
And I actually
loves the show!
Yeah, I interviewed you guys last year! Remember me? Yeah. Okay, but things are a little different in that I was with, I've changed outlets. I have my own show now.
It's, oh, cool. Congratulations.
It's Every Woman TV. So I
Every
should,
Woman
I should
TV.
Be a, I'm Every Woman, like the shock.
Yeah, yeah, it's cool.
So, and I'm so glad that you stopped by to chat with me, because I didn't get a chance to chat with you last year.
Yeah.
And, you know, this is a very special show, because what you're doing is you're portraying women in a very delicate time that was just pre-feminist movement.
Yeah.
And, you know, today, women are suffering with life and work balance.
Mm-hmm.
And I'd like you maybe to, my question is, what do you feel from that time period really that we could benefit from today that really empowered women?
That's a really complicated question. See, sometimes I think it was harder in many ways. And in some ways, sometimes you wish that there was just this kind of, this is what a woman does and this is what a man does, because right now you're expected to be, like when you get married, because you read the things and you think, oh, I should cook, a wife cooks and a wife cleans and a wife takes care of the kids and a wife works full time, and it's just kind of impossible. Whereas Lorna was in that position and these girls were starting to, but it was the beginning of that where you had to try to do everything, and everybody's like, oh, superwoman and you can have it all, but I don't know that you really can have it all. You just have to choose what you want to have and make choices, and I think that it changed everything for women, and in a better way, because you were given more choices. But sometimes, you know, like when I go into a record store or a bookstore, sometimes there's so much choice that I don't know what to, what error, there's so much that it stops me. So I don't know. I think that
I think that was a great answer.
Okay.
And I'm really happy that you gave me that answer, because I see a lot of women struggling and suffering to kind
you
of
know,
be
and that's the thing. And everybody thinks, oh, well, everybody else does it. But it's not true. Like, people are not being honest about what's going on. It is very hard to have a career and be a mom and to do the things that is expected of a woman. It's very hard, and I don't think anybody just does it smoothly. They might say they do it smoothly, but I think that's just giving people an artificial yardstick to measure themselves on. It's challenging. And there's sometimes, no matter what you choose, whether you choose the path to have children and to do that, or the path to work, or the path to do both, you're always going to feel torn in some way.
I think you're right. And I'm actually trying to empower women to have the choice to say it's okay, whatever you choose.
Exactly, it is.
And you're a woman of a great actress. I'm sure it's not easy also to balance an acting career with, you know, being married and mom and kids and all of that either.
Yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And, you know, I know I can't keep you any longer. I'd love to, but I know you want to get going. But if you want to comment to me on how, on that, like, how have you managed as an actress
how
to do
I manage
all
that? Is I did it for a while, and I took my children out, and I always thought I could just take them out of school and get their classes, and then I could, you know, just keep doing that. And then I realized I couldn't, because it was disrupting the continuity in their life. So if they're gone for 3 months from school, their friends are going to be friends with someone else, and they're going to have someone to eat lunch with. And I realized that I had to choose, but I didn't want to have my children raised by somebody else. So I made the decision myself to stop acting. So I stopped acting for 18 years. My children grew up and left home, and I went back. At the time, that seemed like the best decision. And it was the best decision for me. Whether it was the best for my kids or not, I don't know, because maybe it gives them an idea that that a woman's going to make hot breakfast if they get married, for my boys, that the wife's going to make hot breakfast every day. Or maybe for my daughter, I sent a mixed message that, you know, that you can't do one or the other fully. I did it because I needed to for me. I thought I was doing it for my kids, but I find I was doing it for me, so that when challenges happened, I wouldn't say, oh, if only I had tried a little harder. Oh, if only I had been there. You know, I was there. And so I'm glad with my decision, but I know that I made mistakes no matter, you know, no matter how hard you try.
And you know what? I'm so happy that you came by and spoke to me, because I think what you just said is, like, unbelievably powerful and probably one of my best commentary for tonight.
Aww.
And I want to also say I'm glad that you came back, because you
me
are
too. It's
very
fun.
Good actress.
Oh, thank you.
And you look gorgeous, and your skin
thanks.
Is fabulous.
Oh, yeah. Bev actually arranged for me to get my hair and makeup done. I don't normally look this fabulous.
You look fabulous.
Aw, thank you.
Hi, my name is Travis Milne.
And?
Gregory Smith.
And they're from Ricky Blue, ladies. I'm sure you watch them every Thursday. I wanted to ask you, you are working as police officers on Ricky Blue, and some of the major stars and or co-hosts that are also playing police officers are women. So because we are a women's show, I would like a comment from you about how hard is it to be a woman cop police officer working with you men?
Yeah, I feel like in terms of like the way, Rookie Blue is a really great show for that, I feel like, especially like in terms of just the female identity and having to transition into some of these tougher careers. In real life, it's really, really tough. But I feel like we don't necessarily shy away from that. It's still very optimistic, but I think a lot of what happens on the show is grounded in reality. And it's great, like, because the chicks on the show are just tough and fun and awesome and vibrant. And
but some serious subject matter.
Yeah, absolutely.
And do you want to just add some commentary to that? Because I'm actually filming live on location, my show right here, so
oh, wow.
Do whatever you want.
It's a good thing I didn't swear. I love
chicks.
I'd be in so much trouble.
I think you summed it up nicely.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just anything?
Fun. Well, I sort of lost track. What was the exact question again? Sorry, I lost.
The question was, how do you feel it is working on a police officer show, a cop show, with women? Do you feel that it's an honest portrayal? Do you feel it's harder for you to do your job? Do you have any comments to add?
I love working on the show, and all the cast we work with, and the lead girls in particular are amazing actresses, amazing women, and it's an honor to work with them.
Okay, well, thank you very much. Have a great evening tonight.
Hello.
And introduce yourself. We're doing a live on location
okay.
for my show. So what can you introduce yourself?
I'm Kirk Pickersgill, part of Greta Constantine, the Women's Wear Ready to Wear collection in Toronto.
Perfect. You look great.
Thank you.
Love the outfit.
Thank you.
So Women's Ready to Wear, okay.
Yes.
Are you affordable?
To some, not too many.
So what's the greatest challenge in designing a beautiful outfit for a woman?
Well, just knowing what they want, you know, the confidence. It's a natural thing. Yeah.
And when women go looking for that perfect outfit,
they come to us.
Yes, but what's the one thing that they should, you know, really focus on when they really
just
want to look
beautiful? The comfort. It's comfort zone. It's all about the comfort zone.
Yeah.
Yeah. If you don't hit the comfort zone, then you're never going to feel red carpet ready.
And who have you designed for lately?
Lately? I haven't designed...
Give me some names.
Well, we've dressed. I can say we've
okay,
dressed.
Okay, so who's wearing your stuff?
Julie Blackwart the other night at Fashion Cares. Uh-huh. And Chantel. Uh-huh. And Risha Turner. We've designed for many people. Like,
well, you're going to have to design for me next.
Well, I hope so.
Okay. But do you all work together?
Yes, we do. We're business partners, and Antonella works for us.
Okay.
And we have a shop in Rosedale called Petite and Sweet. And
oh,
we
I saw your advertisements for that.
Yeah.
So how's that going?
It's going really well. Yeah, it's awesome. And the show's about us for doing sweet tables for some of the biggest events in the city. And it's been an awesome experience.
Yeah, so you know what? My ladies, and we're doing a live on location coverage right now. I should warn you. Probably are afraid to eat sweets because of the carb count.
What do you have to say about that?
Extra 3 minutes of cardio and you're good. Look, everything in moderation is good. Like, honestly, don't deprive yourself. Have a bit of fun. You live once. It's okay. Everything in balance and stuff is good for you, right?
Yes. Now, is that a South African accent?
It's Australian.
It's Australian. Okay.
Yeah.
It also sounds a tad British.
I did live in London for a while, many years ago, but unfortunately it has stuck. So, yeah.
And are you a graduate pastry chef? Is that what got you into all this?
We're actually event planners and designers, and Yolanda is an amazing, one of the best cake designers in the city. And I used to do catering as well, and it just sort of all came together. And
you're a big star.
Almost. I think so.
Okay, well, you seem very sweet.
Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. You don't want to see me in the mornings.
Maybe I do. Hi, we're inside ET Canada's 7th anniversary party. It's so much fun. We're standing on the rooftop. As you can see, it's wall-to-wall industry people here. We've had some really good messages from some really great stars, homegrown talent and beyond. And we're hoping we're having as much fun as we are. I'm with Roz Weston, one of the senior entertainment reporters from ET Canada, wishing you a happy 7th.
Thank you very much.
And it's a pleasure to meet you.
It's a pleasure to meet you.
Okay. So, Roz, you have two really amazing shows.
Oh, thank you.
How do you do it?
That's why I'm leaving now. We did the cake cutting upstairs for the anniversary of ET, and then I go home right now and wake up at 4 a.m., which kind of sucks because my old days at the film festival and times like this were awesome. I remember when Toronto allowed bars to serve drinks until 4 a.m., and now it's like that's my wake-up time, is I get up at 4 o'clock in the morning every day.
That's not a lot of sleep.
No, it's not. I sleep 5 hours a night. Yeah.
Okay, so we're a woman show, as you know.
Yeah, I love
I'm every
women.
Woman. I'm every
I love
woman.
Women.
I do, you do. I got to ask you a woman's question for
sure.
A woman's show. Would it have been harder for you to have the career that you have presently if you were doing it as a woman?
I'll tell you this. And I put a lot of thought into this. Everybody says television and, you know, show business and radio and broadcast TV is run by, you know, the theory is that it's run by old white men. I have never, ever, ever worked for that white old man. My bosses have only been women. I've only worked for women and one gay guy. My entire career, and the people that gave me my first shots at everything, the people that have employed me and promoted me and given me a chance, all my bosses, the people all above me, have all been women. So for me to say that, the people that I've looked up to that have really driven my career have all been women. And so I don't, like when you ask me a question, could I have done this as a woman? I wouldn't have this career without women. I would not be, if I worked for men with the attitude that I have and the way that I look, guaranteed, if I worked for, you know, a jealous and sort of like alpha males, I would not have the jobs that I do. I have the jobs that I do because of awesome women. Without a doubt, it's because of awesome women.
That is very, I'm glad you said that because, you know, the roles for women in film and TV and even in media, very hard to come by, especially in Canada, because you know we're always competing with the U.S.
Yeah.
So I'm glad to hear that you have that to say, and I'm glad that there's such powerful women that you're telling me about behind the scenes that are running the shows as producers and directors.
Yeah.
And I'm gonna let you go to bed.
Oh,
so
thank you.
It was very nice of you to stop by and talk with us, and I really appreciate it. We are actually filming my show live on location now here.
Brilliant. I love that.
And it was all about how women survive in film and all. I got some great interviews. Thank you for contributing.
I think the main answer to that is, you know, it ain't easy. It's not. But you wouldn't, if you told yourself that it was easy, you would have been lying to yourself.
I went
it's
from being
easy.
A publicist to going back to being a journalist.
Brilliant. Brilliant. Brilliant.
I'm not the one to talk.
Yeah, I love it. I love it. I love it. I love it. But have a wonderful night. Thank you so much.
Obviously.
I'm not a woman. I'm a man.
But you have a lot of experience cooking for women, don't
yes.
you?
Yes.
Okay, so tell me what you're up to. First introduce yourself and then tell me what you're up to.
Chef Corbin on Food Network, working on a new show called Restaurant Takeover.
Very nice. And how's it going?
It's going very well. We just launched this new series 2 weeks ago, and it's doing exceptionally well.
Okay, so now I have to do something that has a little message for women, because that's what my show is about.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I asked Chef Massimo, who was here a little earlier, talking to me, if a woman got a call last minute from her husband and said, honey, I'm bringing home the boss for dinner and had to rush home and make something quick, what would he recommend that she make? And he gave me a great answer, but I want to hear your
answer. So she's bringing the boss home.
No, he's bringing the boss home. She's rushing home from work to make something impressive.
It has like 30 minutes to throw it together.
No,
that's an easy one. What she would do is she would call Chef Corbin, get his catering, unpack it, do it all, throw away all the packaging and say she did it herself.
Okay, and now how can she do that? What's her number?
She can look at me at Chef Corbin on Twitter, or she can get me at chefcorbininc.ca.
Very good. Thank you very much. Have a great night.
Thank you very much.
Goodbye. And we hope you're enjoying our live carpet red coverage at the ET Canada Party. This is their 7th anniversary TIFF. We've had some great interviews tonight with some great stars. And here I am walking the red carpet myself. I want to thank you so much for being with us this evening. And we really hope that you have got some inspiration and some motivation to be all you can be, as you've heard from the different interviews tonight. And I look forward to seeing you next time on I'm Every Woman. Until then, be fabulous.
Sin, don't know when or where to begin.